Hello there, happy Friday. Thank you for your patience if you have been waiting for us to come on at 12:30. A couple of little technical hitches. And you can probably see that I'm inside. I'm not going to be moving as much as I normally do, and I will explain why in a moment. First of all, I hope you had a fabulous, fabulous, fabulous week so far. I've been feeling into the energy of the collective, energy of the group. We're going to go straight in and do the Ho'oponopono prayer, and then I'm going to explain how today's session is going to go. So first of all, I'm feeling very much, there's an awful lot going on in the world. There's so much, we know there's so much going on in the world. And even before I found out what happened, I was outside the other day and went for a walk. I was like, okay, what am I going to talk about for this 2 week session? And it's like, feeling safe as an empath, like, okay. And then, I don't know if anybody saw, then a hedgehog appeared from absolutely nowhere. So signs everywhere. And first of all, I would just like to take us through just the Ho'oponopono prayer, because I kind of feel there's a lot of energy swirling around. We're coming up for a really beautiful moon, a really beautiful full moon in a couple of days, which is all about celebration. There's a lot of things, and I know I keep saying this, there are a lot of things going on in the world. And I feel as healers, as witches, as empaths, as highly sensitive beings, there's certain things going on with us so we can really release like the last little remnants of really what doesn't serve our purpose, so we can be 1,000,000% standing in our power, in our sovereignty, ready to live our life's purpose, ready to do our mission work, which is why we're here. Okay. So first of all, what I would like us to do is just maybe just some couple of gentle shoulder rolls. That would be wonderful. And what I would also like you to do is just close your eyes, place your hand on your heart, and just say to yourself, I am safe. I am safe. I am safe. And what I would like you to have noticed with that is how immediately, just by closing your eyes, just by going in and centering on yourself and placing your hand in your heart, you can already feel those shoulders going down, and you can already feel that you're going from not, perhaps you weren't in the sympathetic system. If you weren't and you were already in parasympathetic, wonderful. What I wanted to do was show there was how it's so easy in everyday life to just get het up in everything that's going on, particularly all the news at the moment, which I'm not going to go into too much because we're going to do the Ho'oponopono prayer. First of all, I just wanted to do that. So I am safe. And just by telling ourselves we're safe, it all goes all the way through our system. You know, our inner child can feel it. We can feel it ourselves. And it's like, oh, actually, it's okay that I haven't done this, that, and the next thing. It's okay that I don't know what I'm having for dinner. It's okay that I'm stuck in traffic and was 5 minutes late for an appointment. It's okay that all of this is going on in my life at the moment. I am safe. Okay, so for some reason it just really felt to come straight in and say that. We're going to do the Ho'oponopono prayer, and then I will tell you how this session is going to go. Slightly different today because it just feels like boom, straight in. And it's really interesting because before I was coming on, I was going, oh, I haven't got the Facebook thing. So it was all going on. And then it's like, really? I'm safe. What's the absolute worst thing that can happen? I'm 15 minutes later coming on than originally planned. What's going to happen, really? So we can really get ourselves wound up with things. And when things are out of our control, then it's about acceptance. It's about, okay, this is happening now. I am safe. I'm going to trust the process, allow whatever's supposed to be happening for whatever reason we were supposed to be on now, not at 12:30, whatever reason that is, I accept it. Okay? So what we're going to do now is go into the Ho'oponopono prayer. Now, this is a really beautiful prayer from Hawaii, and it's the forgiveness prayer. And the reason I love this so much is it really works on yourself. You can also do it with other people. What I'm feeling, because this is all about you, we're talking about empaths, we're talking about embracing yourself, this is stop giving yourself such a hard time. Because as empaths, you know, it's instilled in us to help. You know, we're here to serve. We're here to do all that we can do to help people to help others feel better. And when others feel better, we feel better, so we feel safe. So sometimes we can get into that overdrive of helping everybody, because then everybody's going to feel okay, we're going to feel okay, and then we go, and then we're exhausted. So this is something that you can do. There's another kind of process I'm going to take us through anyway. These first two, I am safe. If you're in a situation where your heart's going a million miles an hour, something's going on, it's in a work situation or you're in a crowd, you can just take yourself away, close your eyes, hand on your heart, I am safe. Immediately works. Okay, so that's the first one. The next one is the Ho'oponopono prayer. So all you're going to do, and I'd like you to do this, just close your eyes, place your hands on your hearts, and then you're going to repeat after me. Now there's four really beautiful sentences, and sometimes I won't necessarily get them in the right order. And you know what? It doesn't matter. It's the intention. So you're going to place your hand on your heart, you're going to close those gorgeous eyes, and at the end of each sentence you're going to say your name. So I will guide you through it, and when you're supposed to say your name, I will say your name. So repeat what I say, and then when I say your name, don't say your name. I know, it's really funny saying the being obvious. So, okay, ready, gorgeous? Great. So close those gorgeous eyes, hand on your heart. I am sorry, say your name. Please forgive me, say your name. Thank you, say your name. I love you, say your name. Now, this is brilliant to do when you feel like, oh, I haven't done this, or I've got all these things to do, I didn't do that for this person. I'll give you an example in a moment of what happened to me a few days ago. So the Ho'oponopono prayer for me is forgiving yourself for what you think you should have done, and forgiving yourself for what you have done. That's all it is. And I've spoken about shoulds before. Shoulds, shoulds, in my opinion, it would be great if it was out of the dictionary, because it's that shoulda, woulda, coulda, I have to do this, I have to do that, this. And when we're in that should energy, shoulders are up, we're not in flow, we're in panic mode of I have to do this, I should, ticking off the to-do list, when actually the to-be list is the best one, ticking, rather than I choose to do this. So I've chosen to come on live today because I know that everything that I'm receiving is for myself and is also for other people who are listening. And there was a moment where I nearly went live just on my, you know, on the Align with Aline business page, because last night I was at the sunset, and I haven't been for a little while because I've had a little bit of an old back injury came up to say hello, and I know why. There's a lot of energetics to it, there's a lot of releasing the last little elements, and so that's why I'm sat inside today. And so the old back injury came up, and for the first time in probably about a week I went outside, and I was just really gently walking with my cats, as I love to do. Sunset was gorgeous, and it was like, actually, it's not about feeling safe as an empath in the Embrace Yourself group, it's for everybody. So I tried to go live on my Facebook business page, I think they call it, on the Align with Aline page, and it didn't work. So I'm live here. What I'm going to do is afterwards download the video, and then I will put it on the page. So that's covered. So, and hello whoever's watching, by the way, lovely to see you. So just to recap, so we've gone through the Ho'oponopono prayer, we've gone through the I am safe. Now what I'm going to do, now we're probably feeling a little bit more relaxed, as I'm going to explain just a little bit of how today's going to go. I had a real idea of what I was going to be talking today, and more often than not, what happens is, just beforehand, I get downloads and say, actually, no, you're going to be talking about this, you're going to be going through this. And also, I experienced what I kind of, what the collective's feeling at the moment, just before coming on. All the fight, flight, freeze. So what we're going to do is I'm going to talk to you about why it's important to feel safe as an empath, how we can feel safe as an empath in everyday life. And then at the end, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about how, if you want to work further with me, how you can. All right? Brilliant. So we've gone through I am safe. We've gone through the Ho'oponopono prayer, easy for me to say. What we're now going to do is I'm just going to talk a little bit and feel any channeled messages coming in about being a highly sensitive empath, being a highly sensitive person, how what's happening at the moment is very much affecting us. Because there are so many of us who have been born, and this is our mission, is to help others. And when we are born to help others, we can go through our whole lives in people-pleasing mode and not really understanding what's going on. When we get to that point where we go, actually, this isn't okay. I'm exhausted. I'm helping you, I'm helping you, I'm helping you, I'm helping you, and I'm on the floor. And that happens to so many of us because we don't have healthy boundaries. Or, well, we don't have healthy boundaries because we have never understood, because nobody in our family has spoken to us when we were children about what was going on with us. Nobody in our teens has spoken to us about what's going on with us. I'm not saying this is for everybody, I'm just saying this is a possibility. So we have thought what our norm is, isn't normal because it doesn't fit in with society. So oftentimes we go into the situation of, right, okay, so I'm not normal. So I need to adapt and change and people please and be who other people want me to be so I can fit in. And when we go into this fitting in stage, we are denying who we truly are. And what's happening at the moment is we're going further and further towards the divine feminine side in the world, and we're opening up to who we truly are. So it may be that you're going through dramatic changes because, and this happened to me, I wasn't listening to the universe of, yep, change that, change that, change that, change that. And because I wasn't, the universe bumped me on my backside 8 years ago. So the only option I had was change. And the only option I had was to go inside and really find out what was going on with myself. So what I would like to say is, as empaths, it's so important to feel safe, because a lot of our life, we've gone through life not feeling safe because we've been trying to fit in, and that can kind of lead to adrenaline overload, shoulders up around the ears, as we're desperately trying to please. And what this does is, it either slowly or quickly, however it works for you, this can really, 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 I want to use the word degenerate. This can be very derogatory to our overall well-being, our holistic well-being, our emotional well-being, our mental well-being, and our physical well-being, because our body takes everything on that we don't deal with mentally and emotionally. So when we don't know how to deal with something mentally and emotionally throughout our lives, it's very, very likely that it went into the body as either chronic illness or injury or accidents or feeling unwell, all of that kind of stuff. Okay, because when we're in a constant state of urgency and panic, we are not in our parasympathetic state. We are in our sympathetic state, which is the limbic brain. So when we were cave people and we were running away from mammoths and saber-toothed tigers, we would go into alert mode. You know, we would have the fight and the flight and the freeze. We would either fight and stand up for ourselves, We'd either run for the hills, flight, or we'd freeze, we'd hide, or we would play dead, for example. And then what then happens is those limbic brains from eons and eons and eons ago are still here. And if our body feels that we're in a state of emergency, then that's what we go into. And that is how we have procrastination. That is how we have running away. That is how we have crippling fear where we hide and we don't want to be seen. And it's all because of that. So this is why it's so important to feel safe as an empath. Oof, felt that. So this is what I really want to talk about. And, you know, I've been there, done that, bought the t-shirt with, I call them the three Fs, the fight, flight, freeze. If you would like to watch, by the way, there's a masterclass that I did a couple of months ago, actually all about this. So if you would like to watch that, that's on YouTube. You can go on there and find the link. I'll pop the link in if you would like to watch that. I'm just brushing on that today because I really want to go through various processes and various ways, especially what's going on at the moment, of how we can feel safe in everyday life. So I mentioned about the, you know, the saber-toothed tiger and the mammoth. So they were our kind of danger when we were cave people. And having those brains still, we're surrounded by information. We're surrounded by constant bombardment, if you like, saber-toothed tigers and mammoths. Because when our limbic brains kick in, it's when there's change. So when we were cave people and there was change, so there's a big boulder coming to block the cave, or, you know, saber-toothed tigers coming along, our brain goes, okay, that's change, that's danger. And the world that we live in now, technology is wonderful. I'm not saying it's not. It's wonderful for communicating and having beautiful relationships with friends all around the world. Absolutely. There is a side to it that, as we all know, it can be addictive. And it cannot be great for our health. So as empaths, as highly sensitive people, feeling, when we're on the internet and we're watching something funny, that can uplift us, absolutely, because laughter is the best thing for breaking energy. And thank you to Crystal T. Perry, one of my wonderful mentors, for saying that. Laughter is one of the best things to just break negative energy. So one of the wonderful things you can do, I'm not saying if you're in a work situation, I would do the safe in the work situation, if you can, is just go away, stick something on YouTube that makes you laugh, watch cats being silly or something, because that will break the vibration that makes you laugh. That's in if you're in a situation which is just uncomfortable at work, for example. So what I'm saying is, the limbic brain that we have now, with the bombardment of information from the news, from the internet, it's all changing. It's constantly changing. It's not a consistent. There's always something new, something new, something new, something new. So our brain, limbic brain's going new, danger, 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 danger. And if you're just, you know, watching hilarious things on the internet, fabulous. If you're watching, if you're spending all your time on the internet and you're scrolling and scrolling and scrolling, and then you're looking at things going, oh, well, look what they're doing, I wish I could do that. Or you're looking at somebody and you're thinking, oh yeah, they've done really well, I haven't done this, I haven't done that. All this is vibration lowering. And I'm not going to go into all the the tricks, should we say, of social media to get us to this point. I'm just going to talk about the positives. So the positives of social media are wonderful, that we're all connected. And what you can do, and I realised this a couple of days ago, I didn't realise you could do this. I kept getting bombarded by various adverts of things that weren't hugely uplifting. So I've gone through my Facebook and I've changed all of my topics. I've changed all the things that I'm interested in, because what they've done is, as we know, Big Brother's watching or listening. They hear everything that's going on. So if you walk past and you've got your phone on and there's the news blaring out of somewhere that somebody's got on the TV, your phone will pick that up and think, oh, she wants to hear about that, or they want to hear about that, or he wants to hear about that. And that's what you'll get bombarded with. So that's one of my little tricks. And I'm still going through it because it takes quite a long time. It's worth it though, because now I adore animals. I'm a complete animal lover. So now my adverts are beautiful, beautiful images and beautiful stories of animals that have been rescued. There was one that came up this morning. And I wasn't scrolling. Facebook's changed, as we know. If you're not paying not to have adverts, you get bombarded with them. So what came up this morning, and it was just gorgeous, it was a mother, a sow and her piglets who had never ever touched grass, being brought out of a trailer and feeling grass for the first time. And that's just like, boom, that's amazing. Another message was how a beautiful dog that's been in foster care for a while has now gone to his forever home. Perfect. That kind of thing. And I'm not saying that everybody needs to listen to that, because we've all got different things that lift us up. That lifts me up. So just making that really small change is massive, because when we're, let's say it how it is. So many of us are on social media a lot because our businesses are on social media, or we want to catch up with friends on social media because we have friends worldwide. That's how it is now. It's wonderful. All I'm saying is, when those adverts start coming up and then we kind of start scrolling, it's really important that whatever you're scrolling to, and I will scrolling through, and I will get back to something about scrolling as well in a moment, whatever you're scrolling is lifting you up. If the first thing doesn't lift you up, I would say put your phone down, send the message to your gorgeous friend, send them a lovely support on their page of whatever they're talking about, and then get off social media before you've changed all your settings. And it's really interesting, because I wasn't going to talk about this, but this is huge to talk about today for some reason, so it's massively coming up. Because I don't know how often you, for example, will go onto social media. I feel it's massively important to have a break from it. And because sometimes, you can put a post on there, it's like, oh, who's liked it? Or has anybody messaged? And then you get all these notifications coming through. It's like, such and such said this, such and such said this. And you start twitching, limbic brain, change. Oh, I must answer that person. I would say to you, allow yourself time off social media or time off your WhatsApp, whatever it is, where you are not answering somebody immediately. If there's an emergency, absolutely. This is creating a really, really good habit. And of course, as I am my business, as business people, and also I'm very aware, being a highly sensitive empath, being a witch, being a healer, being a channel, I massively feel the energy, and if somebody's getting in touch with me, then I really want to help them. What's really important is that we're helping them from a state of parasympathetic flow, not sympathetic flow. So before you rush in and answer anybody's questions, before you rush in and reply to that email, before you rush in and put a love heart for whatever somebody said on your post, take a breath, I am safe. And then if it feels right for you to go in and answer that immediately, do so. If it feels that actually there's no urgency in any of that, I'm going to go away for an hour and do something away from social media, away from technology, just to have my disconnect to reconnect moment. And I would really recommend, oh no, we're inside, I'm going out later. I would really recommend going out into nature. I would really, really recommend that. And especially if you can go without having your phone, if you feel you need to have your phone with you, then switch it off and then know that it's there if you need to have it. It's really interesting the way this conversation is going today. This is not what I thought I was going to be talking about. So this is about the safety element. So particularly social media can really, really rev us up, can really, really put us into fight, flight, freeze, can put us into knee jerk, have to reply to this, have to do this, have to do this, have to do that. I'm not saying don't reply. I'm saying reply in a beautiful flow state, calm, parasympathetic state, and reply with your heart open. So that's massively important. So social media, have a little rest. Social media, if you find that lots of adverts are coming up because they've changed, are coming up and they're not making you feel great, they're not high vibrational, then you can go in and change your topics. That's what I've done recently. And as I said, it's incredible that this is coming up. This is not what I thought we'd be talking about today. Anyway, it's massive. So as highly intuitive empaths, as really, really sensitive people, as witches, as healers, as communicators, as channels, it's so important that we keep our vibration high. It's so important that we keep all around us as a vibrational match. So if something's not matching that vibration, the only way that we can go is whoop. So that's why I would be really, really mindful and heartful of whatever you're watching, whatever you're digesting. And it's not just with food, it's with the TV, it's with the internet, it's with the news, because we all know there's a lot going on in the news at the moment. So that's what I would say. If you can just say, do you know what? That's not urgent for me to respond to at the moment. I need 20 minutes or an hour, even 5 minutes. You could even do it every hour for 5 minutes, whatever works. You just switch everything off, disconnect to reconnect. It feels so huge to say that. So we've done the Ho'oponopono prayer. We've done the I am safe. I'm going to take you through as well. I know we do it every time. This is also brilliant, the stop process. So I understand as well, we don't all work in a capacity where we're working from home all the time. And we can be in environments that there's a lot of people, there's a lot of busyness going on, there's a lot of chatter, there's a lot going on. And sometimes we can get to the point like, I'm not going out. It's like going to the supermarket, for example. I'm not going to the supermarket, there's too much going on, there's the music going on, there's the lights, I can't deal with it, da, 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 da. I'm going to take you through a couple of processes and you'll feel what yours is that really, really helps in terms of going out into public to do chores. And it sounds bonkers. As highly intuitive empaths, as sensitive people, when we go into environments, we can absorb. So one of the things I would say is when you've been out in public is come back and have a salt shower immediately, just get it all off. What I would also say is as you're going into that environment, you say to yourself, I am safe. And one of my gorgeous friends, who's a fabulous astrologer, told me her trick is she imagines that she's surrounded by flowers. So if you imagine you're going to the supermarket or wherever you're going to do your chores and you're just surrounded by flowers, that's a gorgeous one. Another one that I like to do is surround yourself with beautiful pink energy. So put the beautiful, gorgeous energy of love around you. And then if you want to, put gold around that and white around that. I imagine that as an egg. That's how I do that one. Another one that I particularly like, and I'm going through these quickly so and you can watch them back, is another one is imagine yourself in a gold pyramid and you're just surrounded by a beautiful golden pyramid and you're completely, completely safe. And by doing this and saying I am safe, you're going into that environment and you'll notice as well that people will probably be slightly different towards you. Because as intuitive empaths, we pick up on the moods and energies of others, and sometimes our moods can go and turn on a sixpence. And we're like, well, whoa, who's this? What's going on? And we can take that on and take that mood on and take that emotion on. When we go out and we're just very, very gently surrounded by flowers or surrounded by beautiful colours, beautiful pyramid, whatever works for you, it's a complete game changer. Still have that salt shower when you come in. And also I would say this in work environments as well. So if you have to work in a 9-to-5 environment in an office, you know, with other people, or you're teaching other people and you're with them, you're teaching classes, again, I would always put yourself first, prepare yourself in the best possible way, and you say to yourself, I'm showing up in the best possible way that I can be for these people, that I can be for my beautiful students, that I can be for my beautiful work colleagues, that I can be for this beautiful company that I've chosen to work for. And when we change that narrative, rather than, oh God, I've got to go into the office, and oh great, she's over there, they're all bitching about something, and yeah, this is just hell, I can't bear it. When we change the narrative and we say, right, okay, I know there are certain people where I work who are going to have a gossip moment, shall we say. I know there are certain people where I work who are going through something that nobody knows about and are angry all the time or are frustrated all the time, and they don't know what's going on with themselves and they don't know how to deal with it. I am going to accept who they are in that moment in time, and I'm going to still be myself. I'm still going to go in there with my heart open, and with my heart open, I'm going to surround myself with gorgeous protective energy. So the only thing that can get through to me, through my flowers, through my pyramid, through my gorgeous egg, is love. I can only receive good vibrations through. And this is massive at the moment. So I'm not saying go to your boss and say, F off, excuse my French. Maybe that's soon, I don't know. All I'm saying is the world is going through a lot at the moment, and some people don't know what's going on. And so they're going to be showing up, possibly, I'm not saying everybody, they're going to be showing up in lower vibrational states because they don't know what's going on. They haven't done the inner work that you have done. Or you don't necessarily have to have done inner work, there's just a knowing as well. And that's really important as well, that just kind of crashing through comparison. Do not compare yourself. When I'm saying inner work, there's so many different ways to do inner work, and I'll talk about how you can work with me in a moment. All I'm saying is we are not all at the same place, and that's how we chose to come. We're all in different journeys, using that word. We're all here as a collective for a beautiful mission. However, we are here, we have chosen what our lessons are for this lifetime. And these lessons we have chosen are to have experiences so then we can go forward and we can help others with what they're experiencing. So whatever you are at the moment, if there's a feeling at work that just feels fractious, there's a little shift, there's something going on, make sure you're looking after yourself. I'm getting goosebumps with this. Just make sure you're looking after yourself first. And you say, I am safe. And you can even, if you want to, use the Ho'oponopono prayer silently, or you could say it to somebody if you want, see how it goes. you can even do that. And I'm not saying do this if you're feeling guilty about something that you really shouldn't feel guilty about. All I'm saying is if there's something that you feel has upset somebody, which was completely unintentional, you can do the Ho'oponopono prayer. You don't have to have that conversation with them, and you can see that shift. It massively works. What I would like to say is don't start going through and go, did I upset them? Well, I shouldn't have said that. Don't go through that. Just feel into it. Does it feel that the Ho'oponopono prayer is going to help me in this situation? Put your hand on your heart. Yes, no, no. There's nothing to apologize for. And it may be you just need to go back to yourself and apologize to yourself for giving yourself a hard time. That for me with the Ho'oponopono prayer is the main one, is apologizing to yourself for giving yourself a hard time, basically. Because we do, as empaths, we're constantly, oh, I should have done this, I should have done that. The other day, I had the most beautiful moment. I know I'm here to help souls pass. I know that. And many times animals will come to me and I try to help them, I try to keep them alive. And it happened again the other day, just out of nowhere, there was a baby bird in the garage. And the last time there was a baby bird, the parents were around. And so instead of touching the bird, what we did was we encouraged the bird out without touching it, and then the parents were around and then it was absolutely fine. This baby bird had no idea how long it had been in the garage. The garage door had been closed. Just went into the garage one day and there was a baby bird in the middle of the garage on the floor. And a family member said to me, oh, well, you know, that's nature. Then, you know, you just have to let the bird fend for themselves. It was a fledgling, so it had the wings and all the rest of it. And so I gently helped the bird out. It was really, really, really hot. So I put some water down, and then I was preparing a special meal for one of my family members, and I looked out the window and I was like, there's that bird. That bird hasn't got his family and his parents. They've not come down to help him or her. So I went out and the bird kept jumping away from me. I was like, okay, fine. And it was already doing this, you know, when they want food, and this is also a sign of dehydration as well. And so what happened, I will get to a long story short. What happened was then I encouraged the bird to go under a bush because I was thinking, well, at the bird's age, then hopefully they can start foraging for themselves and get the water. They hadn't touched the water. I was trying, when they were going like this, I was trying to get something in there and it wasn't working. And then I had a message. Is that, well, if the baby bird has been pushed out of the nest, which is, nature can be cruel, if the baby bird has been pushed out of the nest because it's not very well, then maybe that's why the parents aren't coming. There were no parents anywhere. There were all lots and lots of birds were talking. There were no birds coming down to help. So I held the baby bird underneath the hedge and then carried on with my day. And then later on in the afternoon, I could just hear all this squawking outside. And what we had done, by the way, before then, is we have cats. So we had arranged for the cats to be inside so they couldn't get out, so the bird could, you know, have free rein, could do exactly what he, she needed to do. And there was just this moment, and it was just complete intuition, is like, go outside, get the bird. So I went outside and the poor little bird was on his or her side, and I took her inside. I'm saying her, I don't know. I put a little pillowcase across my lap and I tried to give water again. No. And I knew that the bird was on their way out. And so I was going through the whole, oh, I should have done this, I should have done that, I should have done this, I should have done that. And then the bird rolled off the pillowcase and onto my lap. And I just went into, you know, I lean out the way into complete, I'm here to help you pass mode. I'm here to help your soul go. My hands are burning actually at the moment there as I'm talking about this. So then what happened was the most beautiful, beautiful moment. The little bird had a little stretch, a little curl up, and then I just felt this love go all the way through me. The bird wanted to be next to my, you know, next to my stomach. It didn't want to be on the pillowcase. And the gorgeous little baby bird passed in my arms. And that was the most beautiful, I can't tell you, it was absolutely gorgeous. It's happened before. And after that, I'm going to get teary again. And after that, I started questioning, what could I have done? And then later, after I'd gone through it and through it and through it, and I always, you know, whenever animals come and they pass, I always take them back to nature and I say, thank you for being here. Excuse me. I got the message. The message that came through was, what if that was the only way that could have happened? I'm like, okay. And I was thinking, well, maybe I should have kept the baby bird in the garage and then tried to feed. And I was like, no, because the baby bird would have possibly been, you know, there were so many narratives going on. And then it was like, actually, what if that was the only way that was supposed to happen? And my message from that was, I was there at the end with that baby bird helping them pass. And as much as I went into, I should have been with the bird all day, that wouldn't have changed the final situation. So I'm talking about this because we can get ourselves into such a flutter when we're trying to help people. And what I would say to you, and I might be slightly tangenting, I'm just getting so many downloads at the moment. What I would say to you is, if you're in a situation and you're helping this person, helping that person, helping that person, helping that person, go through a list. I'm actually doing one at the moment. It'll be available in a couple of weeks. It's a free list for highly sensitive people. It's knowing when to say no as an empath. So if there's a massive emergency, absolutely, you dive in, you do all you can do. That's what goes without saying. If there's somebody who is constantly asking you to do something and it's getting a little bit much, and you do it and then after, and you're feeling like a bit of, to do this again without saying anything. And actually they're perfectly capable of doing what they're asking you to do, then say no. And there are various ways to do this. Like I said, I'm preparing, it's a checklist and it will be available in a couple of weeks. So you can have a look at this, have a look at that. it's going through a series of questions that, is this actually helping them by me helping them? Can they do this themselves? Is this detrimental to my time, my energy, myself? And if you get no's and yeses, then, and you get to the point where it's like, actually, no, there are very gentle ways you can say no. You don't have to offend anybody. It can just be, if it gets to the point where it's like, enough is enough, you can go, no, absolutely not, no more, thank you very much. To gently say no, you can start doing it very gently. You could say, for example, and I did this a couple of weeks ago, you say, for example, I tell you what, you do it and I'll stand next to you. And if you've got any questions, you can ask me. And then also explaining to that person that it's really important that they have experiences and that they trust themselves as well. Because if we just go, no, not doing it, we don't have to justify why we're not. What we can say is, actually, it's not really helping you, me helping you. What's going to help you the most is for you to do this yourself, or you to be this yourself. Like I said, if there's an emergency and you've got a friend who's on the floor, that goes without saying. I'm talking about where there's energy, time on of yours, where you're going into people-pleasing mode, so that person will go, oh, that was brilliant, thank you so much for doing that. And be really honest with yourself. Are you doing that for that dopamine kick of, yeah, that was brilliant, thank you so much for helping me? And it's really interesting when we're honest with ourselves about that. Because are you allowing that other person to value you? Are you allowing those people who you're constantly helping around you to give you your worth? If you feel that's happening, then that's when you really, really step back. And you can say to people, do you know what? I'm actually going to have a month away where I'm going to do some work on myself. And if they say anything negative or anything derogatory, that's their business. It's none of your business what other people think of you, because they're going to see whatever it is from their own stories anyway. This is about making yourself a priority. And it's really, really important to recognize where those boundaries are being stepped over. If every now and then somebody says to you, please could you help me with this? Of course, naturally we can do that. If it's constant, and it's really interesting how it can happen, because it can just feel like, it's only 5 minutes, I can just do it. If those 5 minutes are added up over the year, look how much time and energy and space you've given to somebody else. And look how much of your value of allowing somebody to give you your self-worth from those dopamine kicks. Oh, thank you so much, that's brilliant, you're amazing. It's really, really interesting. And it's really funny that all this is coming through today, because this is not what I expected to talk about. So that's what I wanted to talk about, is feeling safe as an empath and recognizing when you are out of your safety zone because you're in fight, flight, freeze mode of people-pleasing and of helping everybody, in a sympathetic state, in a danger state, because you're waiting for that worthiness to come back to you. That is when we step back and we work on ourselves, okay? So that felt massively important to say. Yeah, I'm going to cry again, I think. So what I'm going to do to finish is I'm going to go through the stop process with you. And then what I'm going to do is talk a little bit about how you can work with me. And then I'm going to just run through what we've covered, just so you know, going off of what you can look at in, you know, for your daily life. So first of all, or actually here's another brilliant one to do before we go into the stop process. So when you're working with healthy boundaries as well, and when you're working on yourself, I've started something, and again, 5 minutes, 2 minutes, however long you can do. I have where I write how I'm feeling in the morning, what's going on in the morning, and then what's happening before I'm going to bed. Because what we're doing as empaths is we're getting it all out of here, which is what we're going to do the stop process anyway, is we're waking up and we're clearing ourselves to go into the day by getting it all down there. And there's a beautiful book called The Artist's Way. And this is one of the main things. She calls it brain dumping. For me, it's just like empaths getting it all out And then sometimes, you know, intuition kicks in. It's like, oh, this would be nice to do. Creativity, you know, sometimes I start writing poetry when I'm journaling. It's really important to get it out somehow. So if you have really, really supportive friends that you can talk to about things, fantastic. If you have a coach that you can talk to about things, fantastic. If you don't have any of these, and be really honest, because as we're going through changes, as our vibrations are going up, sometimes the people around us will start to move away. This has happened to me quite a lot. So this is about really supporting ourselves. So when we're getting it out there, either by writing it down, and you don't have to write it down, another really good thing to do is just to speak it all out into your phone. That's brilliant to do as well. Or you can put some music on and you can dance it out. Or you can get a paint and paintbrush and you know and get it out that way. There are different ways to do this, and I call this meditation because there are different ways that we meditate. You know, we can meditate when we go for a walk, we can meditate in the garden. It's working out what works for us because one size doesn't fit all. So if journaling doesn't feel right to you and you're vocal and you're somebody who talks to themselves, for example, or you use your voice a lot with everything you do, then absolutely for you is speaking into the phone. If you just want to go for a walk in nature, that's a massive meditation. If you want to get the paintbrush out, brilliant. If you want to just put some music on and dance it all out and really feel that, fabulous as well. It's not one size fits all. It's whatever works for you. So that's massively important. And I am going to talk about morning routines as well at some point. I think I'm going over today. there's so much downloading. So I feel actually for the next one, I'm going to talk about morning routines. So that, just to feel safe though, is getting up in the morning, and you can even get up half an hour early before everybody else is up in the house. And if you're in a shared household, and just do what feels right for you. Don't judge it, just do it, just be it, just feel it. So that's massive. So we're going to go into the stop process, and then I will just very quickly summarize a couple of things that, you know, what we've been through, and then I will talk to you how you can work with me as well. All right? Okay, brilliant. So what we're going to do, just some really gentle shoulder rolls. Wonderful. We can already feel becoming more and more relaxed. Close those beautiful eyes. Uncross your arms and your legs, unless you're in the lotus position on the floor. And I'd actually like you just to take a deep breath in and then just let out a ha. That's our hearts. And when we go ha, that's us really connecting with our hearts. So now what I'd like you to do in this gorgeous, relaxed state is feel if there's any noise in your head. Feel if there's any questions, any have to do's, should do's, haven't done that yet, need to phone that person, need to speak to that person, have to reply to that email, yada, 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 yada. If anything's going in there, repetitive memories, repetitive thoughts, all of that stuff. Any negative self-talk that's in there, any comparisons going on, just notice it. And by noticing it in a very relaxed state, it doesn't feel as worrisome, it doesn't feel as burdensome. So you've noticed it now. And now what I would like you to see is the stop sign. So the stop sign is the traffic sign, it's the red hexagonal with the white S-T-O-P, and we're going to work with those four letters. So what I would like you to do is the S of stop we've already done, which is sense. So you have sensed all of the noise that's going on in your head. What I would like you to now do is with the sense is give that an image. So you can give it just a single image. You can give it like a big kind of jumbled mess of words and sentences and phrases or letters, however it looks for you. For me, it's a big kind of doodle spider scroll mess. That's what I see going on in there. And so you just give it whatever that image is. And if you don't see anything, just feel it and know that you're getting exactly what's right for you. Okay? So then the next thing with sense is we're going to take that image that you've given that, or that feeling, all the way out the top of your head. It's going to lift up, 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 go out and over past your face, down past your throat, and then now it's just going to rest in front of your heart. Okay, and then we're going to go back to the stop sign because the next letter we're working with is T, which is trust. And when we listen to our heart, we trust. When we trust, it's from our hearts. So what we're going to do is we're going to trust that our heart has the answers for all of those questions, all of that self-talk going on, anything that's going on in your mind. We're just going to trust that if there are any answers to that, our hearts will give us the exact answer that we need at the right time in exactly the right space, and we just trust that's going to happen. We also trust that if all that is noise, unhelpful noise, there's not going to be any answers, and our heart is just going to transmute that energy into love. Okay? So we sense and we trusted, and we're open to whenever we receive those answers, and we're open to not receiving those answers, and we're open to whatever those answers are from our heart knows. So that's the O of stop. So we've done sense, trust, open. Now we're going to go to P, which is practice. So the P of practice can be anything. You know, I've already mentioned about jumping around and dancing to music. It's practicing anything that's moving energy. So you can practice, go into meditation, you can go into a journey, you can listen to one of mine, you can practice sports, you can practice, go and do some practical cooking in the kitchen, witchy-witchy, anything that feels right for you. Because again, one size doesn't fit all. You're just going to take yourself out of that situation and go and do something else. What I like to do with the stop process is practice being present, because then I'm centered. And I always do this because we're bringing it down. We're bringing whatever we're feeling, we're bringing it down into our body. So I'm centered and I'm present and I'm ready to get on with my day. That's how I love to use the P for present. It can be anything though. If you're feeling that you want to go into, just come back. Just gently open those eyes and come back and just feel how amazing that feels, because that's all out in the heart, completely free. So let's practice being present, because that's where we are at the moment. So you can use this for anything. You can use this in the office, you can use this on the train, you can use this in the subway, you can use this wherever you're going out into public, you know, as well, as I said, as the flowers. You can use it anywhere. And it came to me, I was in a workshop with my fabulous mentors, Crystal C. Perry and Foster Perry, and Crystal was talking about traffic lights, and I saw a stop sign, and then from that, it was downloaded for me, sense, trust, open practice. So that's how it happened for me, and that's how it's massively helped me as well. So the stop process is wonderful. Takes a little bit of time, not that much time. So if you're in a situation, I'm going to go back through what we've said. So if you're in a situation with work and you are not feeling safe, there's something that's happened. I don't know, you've put some presentation forward or you've put some report forward and there's an error in it or something like that. And you've gone into guilt mode. You've gone into, oh my God, the world's about to end, because it does feel like that. You know, it can feel like that if there's somebody criticizing us. I would take yourself off to the bathroom, or take yourself, hopefully you get breaks, take yourself off outside, just place your hand on your heart, close your eyes and say, I am safe. And know that whatever's happening is happening for a reason. It might be that that is the catalyst for you to change and move on to another role. It might be actually that that's an opportunity for you to learn and experience from. And it might also be that that's an opportunity at some point that you can speak to whoever has made you feel unsafe, because they didn't realise they were doing that. So it's changing that narrative on what's going on. So that's what I would do in a work situation. And also, if you're feeling, oh, I did this wrong. So for example, as empaths, you know, as highly intuitive, sensitive people, and really enjoying what we do and wanting everything to be perfect, that perfectionism thing. If there's one little thing out of everything that has been wonderful that isn't quite right, we can spiral down and we can chastise ourselves. So that is when the Ho'oponopono prayer comes in. And I'm not saying everybody does this. I'm saying this is, I would say, this is downloading for me. So I'd say many of us, as highly intuitive people, as empaths, as, you know, childhood experiences, life experiences, we can be massively hard on ourselves. So if something that we've created has been absolutely perfect and there's one thing that's just slightly not there, and we kick into, oh, well, you're useless, well, that's not right, it was ruined now, it's not going to work because of that one little thing, it's all ruined, la-da-da-da-da, perfectionism kicks in, fight, flight, freeze, everything, all the negative stuff comes in. That's when the Ho'oponopono prayer is really good, because you're just stopping yourself, because absolutely the stop process, perfect. You can even practice the Ho'oponopono prayer, actually do the stop process and then do the Ho'oponopono prayer. All I'm saying is choose what feels right for you. So the Ho'oponopono prayer is brilliant to do because you're forgiving yourself for what you think you have done or what you think you haven't done. And you're just saying to yourself, I love you. And really, what has happened? You know, we can do the mountain out of the molehill things and we can get ourselves into such a state because of the perfectionism, because of the people pleasing, that we can just blow things out of proportion. So before it gets to that point, before you're hiding, before you're running, before you're fighting, before you're going into that limbic brain of danger and I'm no good and I'm going to run away because everybody hates me, what I would really suggest you do is just really gently take yourself off, hand on heart, I am safe, Ho'oponopono prayer, and the stop process if you can do it all together. And that felt massively important to talk about today. Massively important. And also, what's just come up as well, I will finish this in a minute, what's just come up also is, I was talking about earlier, so let me go through what I've spoken about. So I was talking about as highly intuitive, empaths, or sensitive people, channels, healers, we're affected by everything around us. So there's the internet, there's the news. So what I would also say, oh, what's that? Never seen that. So if we're feeling like this, let's see if we can do that again. No. So if we're feeling like that, so that's really interesting, and because we've watched something on the news and it's lowered our vibration, and because an advert has come up on Facebook and we've been scrolling through and it's picked up on something that actually lowers our vibration, instead of going into, oh, well, I shouldn't have done that, oh, bloody hell, I've watched the news and now look at me, I'm in this really low vibrational mode, step away, Ho'oponopono prayer, you're good. That's all you need to do. Because it's so easy that when we do that one slight thing that doesn't really match to who we are and our vibration, then we can go, oh, well, I've done that now, so I might as well do this, 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 and this, and then we go boom, 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 boom. No. Just allow yourself, okay, I've done that. I've done that. I watched the news. I knew I shouldn't have watched the news. It's made me feel lower. And I appreciate the experience because it's reminded me that actually the news doesn't really help me, for example. So I'm going to step away and I'm going to do some self-care and I'm going to remind myself of what does work for me. So this is all about feeling safe as an empath. So we've covered the news, the internet, we've covered about what you're allowing into your everyday life. Does it raise or does it lower your vibration? And there's no judgment zone, absolutely no judgment zone. It's just observing and kind of feeling, you know, for example, with me, with what happened with that gorgeous baby bird, instead of going into the focusing on that beautiful moment where a soul was released in my arms, I went into, well, what could I have done better? It's so easy to do. So these are just everyday little check-ins with ourselves. So writing in the morning, dancing in the morning, going for a walk in the morning, preparing yourself to go into work with flowers, with the golden pyramid, with the egg, understanding when people are taking the mickey out of you and allowing yourself to say no and saying to people, actually, by me helping you, it's not really helping you. That's massive. And also allowing yourself to say to people, do you know what, I'm just going to step back for a month and I'm going to do some work on myself. I'm not going to be available. doesn't mean that you retreat from the world. You're just not available in that capacity of doing everything for that person that they're perfectly capable of doing for themselves. Okay? So there we go. Thank you so much for being here. I'm just going to run through a couple of things. If you really enjoy this, please share. I'm going to put it on YouTube as well, because this one really felt today that a lot of people need to, I'm going to use the word need, because there's so much going on. It just felt really important. Everything that was coming through, I really feel there's a lot of people who are going to benefit from hearing this, because there's lots of things that we've spoken about that we know. It's so easy to forget. It's so easy to put ourselves on the back burner. It's just reminding ourselves of it's really important to prioritize ourselves. And this is why I have created the Embrace Yourself group, so you can really embrace yourself. You prioritize yourself. You put yourself first. So that's why every 2 weeks, we're going to go through a different subject of prioritizing ourselves. All right? And we've got this fabulous full moon coming up as well, which is all about celebration. So go and celebrate your gorgeous self. If you would like to work with me on a one-to-one basis, as well as coaching, which you can contact me about, I'm also offering, because there's quite a lot going on, for summer, I'm offering the Empower Hour. And what this is, you get an hour with me. And if there's something that's really, really niggling you, that you've gone through various processes, you can't get an answer for, you're not quite sure what's going on, or it just could be just life in general, book a session with me for an Empower Hour. For July and August, I'm giving the offering at 111 instead of 222 for the hour, and that's pounds. And we will go through, we will get to the root of what's going on. We're not just going to go across the surface, excuse me, throat chakra. We're going to dive deep. I'm going to hold you. You're going to be in a completely, completely safe place. And we're going to feel in together of what is going on. And you will be completely safer there. For there are things where you don't want to go. We don't go there. It's not about that. It's about you in a safe place and exploring what's happening. And we focus on one thing, because we can focus on so many different things and we can go all over the place. We know that as empaths. We can get very easily distracted. So we're going to hone in on something in particular, a situation, something that's going on in your life, maybe relationship, it may be health, it may be wealth, whatever it is. We will go in together and we will start to find gentle solutions so you can start taking action on that. All right, and that's recorded for you as well. And we may go into a guided process, we may go into a guided journey. It's not one size fits all, it's whatever comes through, because there's going to be elements of channeling and there will be elements of intuitive messages as well, because I will be connecting with your energy and feeling what's going on. And also, you will be connecting and feeling what's going on. It's not just me saying to you, you need to do this. We will work together and we will feel what comes out and how feels great for you with those solutions to take that action. All right? So thank you so much for being here with me. I said half an hour, 40 minutes. I think we've come to an hour. So sending you so much love. Thank you, my gorgeous, for coming on and being live with me. So much love, wishing the most amazing of full moons, and we will be back outside under the tree of love next time. As I said, had a little back thing that happened, so I'm just on a comfy chair. There's a lot of beautiful things going on where I am at the moment anyway, so I hope you felt the magic as well. Sending you so much love. Embrace yourself. You are fabulous. Remember that. Ho.